And today, the membrane. So first, come on, point number one, it is the process by which small molecules are forced to move across our semi-permeable membrane. What? It is the process, wo process jiske zariye very tiny and small molecules are forced, are not moved, are forced to move across our semi-permeable membrane with the help of blood pressure और हाइड्रोस्टेटिक प्रेशर. सो वो प्रोसेस जिसमें बहुत छोटे मॉलिक्यूल्स को फोर्सफुली हम मूव करवाते हैं थ्रू द सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन. सेमी परमिएबल मीनिंग पोरस मेम्ब्रेन, जिसमें छोटे छोटे पोर्स होते हैं जिससे स्मॉल मॉलिक्यूल्स वन मेम्ब्रेन से दूसरे मेम्ब्रेन के अंदर मूव कर सकते हैं. उस प्रोसेस को कहते हैं फिल्ट्रेशन. And the molecules, small molecules are moved forcefully. जब हम किसी चीज़ को फोर्स करते हैं तो हमें एनर्जी लगानी पड़ती है, फोर्स लगानी पड़ती है. तो किस वो फोर्स कहाँ से आती है? विद द हेल्प ऑफ ब्लड प्रेशर. द फोर्स कमिंग फ्रॉम द प्रेशर ऑफ द ब्लड और द हाइड्रोस्टेटिक प्रेशर. हाइड्रोस्टेटिक मीनिंग वाटर प्रेशर. वाटर से जो हमें हमारी बॉडी के अंदर जितना वाटर होता है उससे जो हमें प्रेशर मिलता है, प्रेशर इज फोर्स. So when small molecules are forcefully moved from one membrane, from one semi-permeable membrane into the outer or the inner environment with the energy coming from the blood pressure or the water pressure is called filtration. And the key point about the filtration is that only small molecules are moved or forced across the membrane. No large molecule, all the molecules which are larger in size cannot move. For example, this is a diagram of capillary. Capillary is the blood vessel in which gaseous exchange takes place, and the small molecules are moved from the capillaries into the organs for the utilization for the different processes. You can see here the small dots are moved forcefully from the capillary into the outer environment. This is a capillary. As you can see, it is porous, mean it is semi-permeable. It has pores in it for the movement of molecules from the interior to the exterior environment. These small dots are the small molecules, and these larger molecules are the big molecules which are large in size. That's why filtration is not for large molecule. Filtration is only for the small molecules. When the molecules are passing into the capillaries, these are forcefully moved from the interior to the exterior environment. This process is called filtration, and it occurs with the help of blood pressure. As we know that the blood is passing across the capillaries, and blood also has water in it. So the pressure which is required to move small molecules from the capillaries into the exterior environment, this is the blood pressure or the hydrostatic pressure. Hydro meaning water pressure. Only small molecules are moved, okay, in the filtration. Now the next topic is active transport. Active meaning with the help of any kind of energy. All the processes which we have studied earlier are the passive transport, in which molecules are moved from higher to lower concentration without the help of any kind of energy. All those processes were included in the category passive transport, because in passive transport no energy is required, because molecules are moving from higher concentration into the lower concentration. Today we will study how molecules move from lower to higher concentration.
In active transport, molecules move from lower to higher concentration with the help of energy in the form of ATP. ATP stand for adenosine triphosphate. अब जितने भी हमने पहले प्रोसेस पढ़े उसमें मॉलिक्यूल्स मूव करते थे लोअर हायर से लोअर कंसंट्रेशन में. जब एक चीज़ हायर से लोअर कंसंट्रेशन पे जा रही है वो तो खुद ही मूव कर रही है क्योंकि उसको स्टेबिलिटी अचीव करनी होती है. लेकिन जब हम एक्टिव ट्रांसपोर्ट की बात करते हैं उसमें मॉलिक्यूल्स खुद ब खुद ही लोअर से हायर कंसंट्रेशन की तरफ मूव करते हैं. और जब हम लोअर से हाई कंसंट्रेशन की मूव करेंगे तो हमें किसी ना किसी एनर्जी की हेल्प की ज़रूरत होती है. ठीक है, तो हमारी बॉडी में जो भी हम एनर्जी यूटिलाइज़ करते हैं द एनर्जी विच वी गेट फ्रॉम आर फूड इज़ इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एटीपी. एटीपी इज़ अ मॉलिक्यूल एंड ऑल द एनर्जी इन द इन ह्यूमन बींग्स आर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एडीनोसिन ट्राइफॉस्फेट. ओके, this is a base, this is a chemical. okay, the energy in the human being is in the form of ATP. ATP stands for adenosine triphosphate. active transport include the movement of molecules from lower to higher concentration with the help of energy, any kind of energy, but in human beings this energy is in the form of ATP. now look at book, page number 73. Suppose this is the any kind of cell present in the human body or the plant body. This is the interior of the cell, K positive and Na plus positive. K is the potassium and Na is the sodium. We have studied it in chemistry. Okay, as you can see, this is the outside of the cell. This is the semi-permeable membrane having a pore in it and a large molecule which has energy in the form of ATP. Look here, how many sodiums are present here? 1, 2. And how many outside the cell? 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the lower concentration, lower number of sodium, and this is the higher concentration, high quantity of sodium. So the sodium, by utilizing the active transport, will move from the inside of the cell by utilizing the energy in the form of ATP to the exterior of the cell, because the number of sodium here is 4, but in this inside this is 2 sodium molecule. So this is the active transport in which molecules move from lower to higher concentration, because this is very unusual phenomena. That's why it requires energy in the form of ATP. So in the active transport, molecules move from higher concentration lower concentration in which they are less in quantity towards the higher concentration in which they are higher in quantity. Active transport is the movement of molecules from an area of lower concentration. So active transport is the movement of molecule from an area of lower concentration to the area of higher concentration. This movement against the concentration gradient requires energy in the form of ATP. In this process, carrier proteins or in this diagram, this is the carrier protein in the form of ATP. In this process, carrier proteins of cell membrane use energy to move the molecule against the concentration gradient. For example, the membrane of nerve cell have carrier protein in the form of sodium potassium pump. In the resting, not including nerve cell, this pump send energy to maintain higher concentration of sodium and lower concentration of potassium and lower concentration of sodium inside the cell. For this purpose, the pump actively moves sodium to the outside of the cell where they are already in high concentration. Similarly, this pump moves sodium from outside to inside of the cell where they are high in concentration. Okay, the movement of molecule from the lower to higher concentration with the help of any kind of energy. This energy can be in the form of ATP. This process is called active transport. Active meaning very energetic, in which energy is required. Okay, Allah Hafiz, thank you.